Welcome you back for the further sessions in the additive manufacturing process. In the previous session, what we discussed in detail with respect to the classification of the additive manufacturing process. Now, in a simpler way, the additive manufacturing process, it can be classified into four types. The first one is nothing but a liquid polymerization systems. The second one is the discrete particle systems. The third one is a molten material systems. And the fourth one is the solid sheet systems. The first one what we are discussing is the liquid polymer systems. As the name itself is suggesting that it's a liquid polymer system. The polymers, it will be in the form of a liquid. The polymer what we are using in this process is also a photopolymerizing liquids normally. The first process what we are discussing is the stereolithography apparatus, or it's also called as stereolithographic process. The 3D systems or the 3D printing systems was first founded in the year 1988 by Charles, and the same is further modified and as well as commercialized by the Fried in 1988. The principles of the SLA or stereolithographic apparatus. The stereolithographic process is based on the liquid polymerization system. The parts are built on a photocurable liquid resins that are cured when exposed to a laser beam or photopolymerization, which scans across the surface of the resin. The schematic diagram shows the SLA process, which consists of a bath. In the bath, which consists of a elevator which can be moved up and down by the motor, and also it consists of the laser beam which cures the photopolymerizing liquid by using a laser beam or a UV curable liquids where the UV light is used as a media. Now the building is done by layer by layer. Each layer is being scanned by the optical scanning systems and controlled by the elevation or the elevating mechanism which lowers at the completion of the each layer. Stereolithography process creates a 3D plastic objects directly from the CAD data. The process being with a vat filled with a photocurable liquid resin, and the elevator table sits just below the surface of the liquid resin. A 3D CAD solid model files is loaded into the system by the operator. Once if the 3D drawing is loaded and the same is converted into a STL file, the supports are designed to stabilize the part during the building process. The translators converts the CAD data into an STL file. The control unit slices the model and supports into a series of cross sections of 0.025 to 0.5 mm thick. The optical scanning system directs and focuses the laser beam to solidify the 2D cross section corresponding to the slice on the surface. The photocurable liquid resin. The elevator table drops enough to cover the solid polymer with another layer of the liquid resin. A leveling wiper or the vacuum blade moves across the surface to recoat the next layer of the resin on the surface of it. The laser then draws for the next layer. The process continues to build the part from the bottom up until the system completes the part. The part is then raised out from the vat solution and cleaned, and excess of polymer is removed by the other secondary process. The applications. The model for the conceptualization or even the packing and the presentations and the prototype models can be very easily designed and as well as fabricated, and the verification and the functional testings can also be done. The parts for the prototype tooling and a low volume production tooling can also be fabricated very easily. The patterns for investment castings and sand castings and for the moldings can also be fabricated very easily. The tools and fixtures and the tool design and the production toolings are not at all required in this process. The main advantages: SLA processes builds the complex geometrical parts which cannot be easily fabricated in the conventional manufacturing process. High quality of the surface finish can be achieved very easily. Clear models with a good resolution can be achieved very easily. The next process is nothing but the direct discrete particle systems. The discrete particle systems is also known as the powder based systems. Here the powders are graded into a uniform particle size and the shape and the narrow size distribution. The finer the particle and better the results. If the two small powders are used, then the controlling and the distribution and also the dispersion of the particles will be a difficult. In the 1D approach, using a laser, we can produce a thermal energy in a controlled manner so that the temperature increases to melt the powder. The polymer powder used should exhibit thermoelastic behavior so that they can be melted and remelted to permit the bonding on the one layer to another. The two polymer based approaches commercially available are SLS technology, marketed by A3D Systems. SLS is nothing but a selective laser sintering. The main principle with respect to the selective laser sintering is the parts are built by the sintering when the CO2 laser beam hits a thin layer of the powder particles or the powder materials. The interaction of the laser beam with the powder resin and the temperature to the point of melting, resulting the particles in bonding and fusing the particles themselves to the previous layer to form a solid component. The building of the part is done layer by layer. Each layer of the build process contains the cross section of the one or many parts. As we know that more number of parts, it can be processed very easily in the case of the 3D manufacturing, or it may be additive manufacturing. For that reason only it is mentioned as one or many parts. The next layer is then built directly on the top of the sintered layer after the addition of the layer of the powder is deposited via by means of a roller or which is on the top of the previously formed layers. SLS, which is nothing but a selective laser sintering. Selective laser sintering involves the fabrication of the model by means of selective melting the powder materials layer by layer. In this process, CO2 laser is used as a media to harden the material. Before the powder is sintered, the entire bed is heated just below the melting point of the material in order to reduce the thermal distortion and facilitate the fusion to the previous layer. The geometry of the object is created in the CAD model and it is converted into a STL file, and the same is transferred to the machine. The STL file is then sliced and drawn into one cross section at a time. The laser selective fuses the powdered material by scanning the cross section of the object on the surface of the powder bed. After each cross section is scanned, the powder bed is lowered and one layer thickness of is built over the platform. A new layer of the material is applied on the top of the processed material. Compared to the other process, the relatively a wide range of powder material can be used in this process. Polymer powders like nylon, glass, filled nylon, or even the polystyrene, or even the metal powders like either it may be a steel or titanium or even alloys can also be used in the process. The main advantage of this SLS process are, a wide range of materials can be used and post-cure is not necessary. Unfused powder acts as a supporting material. The support materials can be easily removed. The applications: fit and function prototype for the mechanical and as well as the thermal test. The small plastic parts can be used for the rapid tooling applications, like the injection molding can be used for the soft tooling and the short run production. The schematic diagram shows the SLS, which consists of the three part. One is with respect to the powder feed piston. The another one is nothing but the built up chamber. The third one is the built portion, or it may be a built up chamber. And the third chamber is nothing but a powder feed supply. There are two powder feed portions, because even in the forward motion and as well as even the backward motion, the powder, it can be fed into the what we can say, the built up chamber, where the layering over the built up layer, it can be done very easily, and the parts can also be fabricated easily. The schematic diagram consists of the three chambers and a powder feed roller, and also a scanning the laser, CO2 laser, by which the CO2 laser is tracked to the built-up chamber where the hardening of the material is taking place.